they should all get the same information, they should get it at the same time, they should get it with the same degree of candor, regardless of the amount of shares they own. Now, the most efficient way to communicate with hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of thousands of people, which we have at Berkshire, you know, is through the written word. And I try, once a year, I try in an annual report to tell them what I would want to learn if our position was reversed. In other words, in my mind, I have two sisters, Doris and Bertie, and they have significant percentages of their net worth in Berkshire, very significant. They're smart, but they're not spending all their time reading financial reports or the financial page. I pretend that they have been away for a year. They've come back and they've written me a letter. They say, Warren, what's going on? And then I write a letter and I say, Dear Doris and Bertie, and then I write a letter to them, and I tell them what I would like if our position was reversed. And when I get all through, I take off the Dear Doris and Bertie, and then I mail it out to the shareholders. In my view, that's what should be done. I mean, we've got an economic principles section of Berkshire Hathaway at the back of the report that's been there for 30 years. I mean, we want, those people are our partners. I want them to know, just as I want my sisters to know, we have a private company, there were three of us in it. I want them to know what my partner Charlie Munger and I, who run the place, think is important. I don't want to give them so much information that the obfuscation sets in. I want to talk to them about what's important to me, what I'm thinking. I think every company should do that. Now, I think if you want to have some continuous dialogue through the year, most companies have investor calls and that sort of thing. I read those things like crazy, and I spend a lot of time reading them. But if I ever instituted something beyond what we're doing, I would probably say, send along questions, and every Saturday morning, because I'd want the market to have the maximum time to digest any new information, that if any of those questions were the kind that I would expect from my sisters, important to the shareholders, that I'd put the question, I'd put my answer up on the internet, you know, where everybody'd have a couple days to digest the answer. I mean, any information that I've miscommunicated, and I should have communicated earlier, and somebody comes along and says, how about this, or there's something in the paper that's important, I would try to give the same answer to everybody at the same time. And the best way to do it, you know, is in my view, would be to put it up on a Saturday morning. We try to release all important information. We can't do it. We bought a company, agreed to buy a company the other day, so we have to announce it. But I try to put up important information after the close on Friday, because that gives people a maximum amount of time to read sometimes complicated information in our 10Q before the market opens on Monday, and they can read it if people want to blog about it or anything else. And, I don't think it's hard to have an effective communication vehicle with millions of people if you really want to do it. I don't like talking to institutions to the exclusion of individuals. I mean, that just kind of goes against the grain with me. We like people to come to our annual meeting. You know, most managements, you know, try to figure out some place in Alaska or something and get away with it. But I think it's wonderful. I mean, we want to get owners who, when they buy our stock, expect to own it for the rest of their life. I own a farm I bought in the 1980s. I own some real estate in New York I bought in 1991, a piece of something. You know, I didn't buy it because I was going to get a quote every day. You know, I haven't had a quote on my farm since 1985. What difference does it make? I look at what the farm produces. I want to know, like, you know, whether we can get more corn and soybeans per acre because developments have been made. So, what's the difference? I mean, investment is laying out money now to get more money back later on. You know, and whether it's in a farm or apartment house or Berkshire Hathaway, you should be looking at the asset, the business itself, and we want to tell people about that business. And those are the shareholders we want. And some of the, we don't want shareholders to buy it because they think you're going to sell it for more next month. You know, but we do want shareholders to think it's a wonderful thing to own for the rest of their lives.